Hi, I'm Matthew Lapp, host of Matthew Lapp Train Guy segment show. Also today in this segment, I'm at the New London Heritage Historical Village in New London, Wisconsin. The New London Heritage Historical Village is located on 900 Montgomery Street in New London, Wisconsin, and is in Memorial Park in New London, Wisconsin, and is open likely by appointment. The New London Heritage Historical Village was started in 1987, and it features six of New London's historic buildings that were moved to the village for preservation: octagon-shaped house, a one-room school, a little white chapel, log cabin, Simmons Garage. It even features railroad items such as the New London Depot that was once used by the Chicago Northwestern, as well as a caboose from that railroad, a caboose and boxcar from the Soo Line, and a diesel that was once used by the United States Army and Leona Northern Railroad as well. What you see right behind me is the Chicago Northwestern New London Depot.
The Chicago and Northwestern New London Depot was built in 1923 and originally sat next to the railroad tracks that went through New London, and replaced the original station that dated from the original station that dated from the 1870s. In 1905, 8 passenger trains per day called at New London. Trains with the names such as the Flambeau, the Twin Cities Express, the Fox River Express took travelers to cities such as Chicago, Milwaukee, Minneapolis, and Ashland. Also, it served for passenger service on the Chicago Northwestern Railroad in New London, Wisconsin, many years ago, and people would even buy their tickets inside and also board a train to going somewhere or arriving on a train from somewhere. The last passenger and mail trains came through New London in 1954. Freight trains continued to use the depot until 1982, when the railroad closed the agency. Then later on, the depot was retired and it was empty for several years and was then moved to its current location at the entrance to Memorial Park in 1987, and then got moved to this spot at the park. Today, it features on the inside memorabilia of both the Chicago Northwestern and Soo Line Railroads.
Okay, I'm going to show you all the exhibits inside the depot, and I'll get behind the camera and show you around in there. So here we go. Okay, here is a board that has many historic photos of steam engines. And here's a poster about the trains around the area, and that looks like a Metra diesel right there, an old grandfather clock. Let's go into this room. In this case, you'll see some historic train items, and on this, and look here, in this other case, Chicago Northwestern memorabilia. Wow, a lot of history they have preserved here. Look at this bell on the floor and all these lanterns, these locks, and everything. Even this switch stand. And that's just about it. And look at that old phone. And here's some maps on the wall. And that's cool. Okay, you can see right here are two flatbeds in front of the diesel locomotive. These were used in maintenance of way use before being acquired by the organization here at the New London Heritage Historical Village in New London, Wisconsin. Okay, what you can see right here are several switch stands in front of the flatbeds, and they're at this end of the track on the train display track, and they have a good collection of switch stands. There's more beside the depot, and I'll show them to you. Okay, you can see right here three more switch stands that are preserved here at the New London Historic Village in New London, Wisconsin. And here they are, like I mentioned, next to the depot. Okay, you can see behind me is a signal that is next to the yellow caboose here at the village, and it's been used at a railroad crossing to alert people, to alert trains when to stop or go, and it's a signal hand that would go up or down, like you can tell by the lights how it indicates. And now here it is preserved at the New London Heritage Historic Village in New London, Wisconsin. What you see right behind me is Leona Northern 101.
Leona Northern 75618 was built by Vulcan Ironworks in Wilkes-Barre, Pennsylvania in 1941 and is the 4337 diesel locomotive built by that factory and is a 65-ton type diesel locomotive. This locomotive was originally used by the United States Army and was originally numbered 4554. And it was even used for switching cars around as well, and even moving Army equipment on rail cars as well, and even moving rail cars loaded with Army equipment as well. Then it was renumbered 7435. Then it was likely used by Connor Land and was renumbered 101. Then it was sold to the Leona Northern Railroad and retained its number. Then it was soon retired, and in 1999 it was donated to the New London Heritage Historical Village in New London, Wisconsin by Robert Pulaski, who may have previously owned it and donated it to the New London Area Historical Village in New London, Wisconsin, where it is today.
What you see right behind me is Soo Line 75618.
Soo Line 75618 was built by American Car and Foundry in St. Charles, Missouri in 1924 and is an outbraced boxcar. This car was used for carrying cargo such as boxes, crates, merchandise on board many years ago. Then the car was retired and was then acquired by the New London Heritage Historical Village in New London, Wisconsin, where it is seen on display today.
What you see right behind me is Chicago Northwestern 111-53.
Chicago and Northwestern 111-53 was built in 1968 and is a steel bay window caboose. This car was used on freight trains on the railroad for many years and was used as the train crew's office and is one of many Chicago Northwestern bay window cabooses used on the railroad as well. Then later on, the car was retired, and in 1993, it was put on display here at the New London Heritage Historical Village in New London, Wisconsin, where it can be seen on display today, and you could even visit the interior of it as well.
What you see right behind me is Soo Line 138.
Soo Line 138 was built by the Lafayette Car Works in Lafayette, Indiana in 1888 and is a wooden caboose. This caboose was used on the Soo Line Railroad as the train crew's office and would also be used on the back of freight trains for the railroad as well. Then in the 1960s, the car was retired and was donated to the New London Heritage Historical Village by William Winkler, who may have previously owned the car, and was moved to the location in 1990, where it can be seen today. And also, you can even visit the interior of it as well.
What you can see right behind me is this crossing signal that was used at railroad crossings years ago before being moved here to the New London Heritage Historical Village in New London, Wisconsin. Now here it is, right next to this church. Well, I hope you all enjoyed learning about trains with me today in Matthew Lapp Train Guy Segment Show. Also, I hope to see you all again in the next segment. And if you didn't subscribe to my channel yet, the subscribe button is just down below the video screen. And if you didn't give my Facebook page a like yet, here's where you'll want to go. And if you didn't give the Instagram page a follow yet, here's where you'll want to go as well. Also, be sure to get your merch at teesprings.com. The link is in the description box below, along with the Facebook and Instagram pages. And remember to subscribe to the Train Guy. So this is Matthew Lapp, host of Matthew Lapp Train Guy Segment Show. Sign out. Until next time, all aboard.